guys. Welcome to my Ocean One channel. I got a few things on my mind I want to talk to you about. First of all, we had a nice little rally today. I have no idea why. Nice little pop. Who knows? Could be anything. Could be nothing. I'm just curious if my audience... let me try it this way. My audience is very mature. Now, obviously, my audience is all about Fisker. You know, I am too, of course. And I'm going to follow this through until the end, whether that's, you know, bankruptcy, whether that's restructuring, whether that is we get a buyer, whatever it is. I want to follow this through because I have dedicated the last 4 years of a big part of my life into investing in Fisker. And quite honestly, that's turned out to be a horrendous decision financially. Financially, you know, I've been, let's just say decimated, just like the share price. You know, I was buying shares at 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, you name it. And I purchased all the way down and, you know, I basically made a one-sided trade all the way down, even though I sold calls and puts all the way down. I always made a one-sided trade. I was always bullish on Fisker. And I am just curious if some of you in my audience would like for me to change directions on this channel. Now, I want to be clear about what I'm thinking, okay? I am going to stick with covering Fisker, okay? But I'm also thinking about turning my channel into Ocean One and More. You know, I don't know, just a title, okay? Ocean One and More. And the More being outside of Fisker, and the More could be following my journey. You know, I don't know, to pay the ocean down, you know, because I'm upside down in it. And starting over, because basically I have very little money to work with, you know, as far as what I'm used to. So I'm starting from a very tiny amount of money and walking you guys through some of my trades. Now, what I'm thinking about doing is showing you guys how to sell calls and sell puts, and how I would structure those trades during the week. Now, I've thought a lot about this, and if I do this, I'm not going to do it in real time. I don't think that's practical for me. I don't think that would work, and I don't want to be responsible for anybody's losses or gains in any way. My channel would just be to show you how I am doing it, how it went that week, you know, do a video at the beginning of the week, maybe in the middle, maybe at the end to show you how the trades are going, how they went, and basically teach you guys how to sell calls and puts and, you know, in a stock or two or three. And I have been looking at a few stocks and I am currently selling some calls and puts in other stocks. I'm just curious if you guys would be interested in, you know, me doing that. Is that something that you guys would like for me to expand the channel into? Obviously, while still covering Fisker, but you know, I can't sell calls and puts on Fisker right now, and I've always done that is generating an income, and I would like to, you know, build my share balance. Maybe I shouldn't say share balance. Build my cash balance back up to, you know, a more meaningful level after being totally decimated in Fisker. Sorry. I had a person reach out to me and, you know, they had lost a substantial amount of money in Fisker and they had lost a substantial amount of money in another stock, Amorous, as a matter of fact. And, you know, they were asking me how I deal with this. And I'm like, I deal with it fine. You know, yeah, I've lost a lot of money. Yeah, I'm disappointed over that. But you just have to start over. And he was like, how do you start over? And I'm like, You just start over, man. That's what you do. You just start over. You don't let this get you down. You just start over. So I'm curious if you guys would be interested in maybe this channel broadening into something like that. I don't know how detailed it would be. I do think it would definitely be a work in progress, and I could take suggestions from you guys and stuff like that. I'm just curious what you guys think. Is that something that you would be interested in following? Now, disclaimer here, of course, I would still do my YouTube disclaimers, obviously, because I do not want to be responsible for anybody's losses or gains. You would be responsible for every single trade that you do, whether it went up or whether it went down. But I could kind of show you how I do this and how I approach it, and I don't know. See if you guys would be interested in that or not, because obviously I can't sell calls and puts on Fisker, and I do want to start over. So I have been looking at a few other stocks, and I have already been doing that a little bit. And I was just wondering if you would like for me to share that with you guys. So anyway, let me know what you guys think. Let me know your thoughts in the bottom and see if that's something that you guys might be interested in. If it is, I'm definitely giving it a thought. I'm definitely leaning in that direction. I'm just curious, what you guys think, because you guys are already my audience. Now, obviously, I would expect to lose some and gain some, but I do really respect my followers on this channel because all the comments are almost always respectful. So I think I got a good group here and got a good thing going on. And I'm just trying to find a way to continue the channel and continue this journey because a lot of people are going to be like me. They went all in on Fisker and we struck out. That's life, man. Sometimes you get the bear and sometimes the bear gets you. And the bear definitely got us here. And on a final note, again, as I always say, no one would be happier to see this company survive. I would love to see Fisker survive and come out of this. But anyway, let me know what you think about this and see if you're open to that direction and maybe what your comments are. Just let me know in the bottom. All right, guys, thanks a lot, and until next time.